Just on travel restrictions, I know we're waiting for more information on the kind of checkpoint system this week, but have you considered, or is there any way to tie these travel restrictions into the air system, which I realize is federally regulated, but, you know, someone getting on a flight in Kamloops, landing in Victoria, not having to go through the same restrictions of the ferry terminal, for example. Is there anything BC can do on that? Is that on your radar, or is that just outside of your jurisdiction?
Well, jurisdiction matters not to the people of BC. What they want is results. This is not unlike the last question, Rob, in that the federal government had undertaken a national program that didn't meet the test. The federal government also brought forward border restrictions at our urging, again, over a year ago, and we supplemented that by sending provincial public employees to assist federal workers so they could get a program in place to manage and monitor our international borders. With respect to people coming from other parts of Canada, I have been appealing to my colleagues in Alberta and across the country to stay home. I've been saying that like a broken record for months and months, and I'm grateful now that I'm hearing from other premiers in other parts of the country. They're not only urging their citizens to stay home, they're directing them to do so. So with respect to interprovincial travel, these are challenges, and particularly with Alberta. And I don't say that in a negative way. We have so many economic, social, and cultural connections to Alberta. People are going back and forth in border communities like Grand Prairie and Dawson Creek and Elkford and the other communities along the Alberta border into British Columbia. And so it's extremely difficult to manage and monitor those issues. British Columbia was not built to be exclusive. It was built to be inclusive. We have been doing everything we can to build transportation infrastructure to welcome people to British Columbia, not to discourage them coming. So these are big challenges. We're aware of them, and we're appealing to our colleagues across the country to reinforce with Canadians that now is the time for the next 4 weeks. Let's get to the May long weekend. Vaccinations are coming thick and fast. We have seen a flattening of cases here in British Columbia and a decline in hospitalizations. We need to keep at the front of our minds the tireless work of healthcare providers that have been at the task for 14 months now with little chance of a break. Now is not the time to indulge ourselves. Now is the time to focus on our collective responsibility to bend this curve, bring down the case count, get the vaccine that's offered to you as quickly as you can, and let's get the summer going, and let's get on with programs like NBC to build the British Columbia that we all want.
Hi, Premier. Just back to the travel issue. Would you be in support, if it were able to be done, a regime where even people traveling within Canada would have to have a negative PCR test before they get on a flight?
Well, again, if it were possible is the key to your question. And it's also the key to many other questions. And what we've discovered as a government over the past 14 months is that the professional public service is extraordinarily adaptable to diverse and unique situations that none of us have ever contemplated. Being able to pull together programs like the circuit breaker resources that Minister Callon and his team have put together in lightning speed is not what government is built to do. It's traditionally characterized, and I know I'm not looking to Greg to confirm this, but it's traditionally slow, methodical, and focused on the status quo. What we've needed and what we've got, quite frankly, from the professional public service over the past 14 months is nimble, adaptable, focused programs on the needs of sectors as they've emerged. And that's involved collaboration with the private sector, talking to industry leaders, talking to working people and the unions that represent the many, many companies that have been able to continue operating, quite frankly, over the past 14 months, finding a way for all of us to get through this. And on the issue of interprovincial travel, my view is the best course of action is to tell people to stay home. And what we've seen over the past 7 days is results from that approach, with the focus on enforcement to come later in the week. Making the case that it's important for people to stay local has worked this week, and it needs to work for the next 4 weeks so that we can salvage the summer.
Regarding the travel restrictions, I'm asking on this behalf of another reporter. They're getting a lot of questions about when we're going to see the enforcement. We've been hearing about this for a couple of weeks. This reporter has heard from RCMP that they haven't given a single $575 ticket, don't intend on stopping people. So what actually is happening on the ground, or when will we see this happening on the ground?
Well, I think Minister Farnworth's been pretty clear. This is a two-step process. We announced the restrictions last week, and we'll announce the enforcement later this week. It's in his hands. As you know, law enforcement is not directed by politicians. Thank goodness for that. We lay out the orders, we lay out the laws, and it's up to law enforcement to deploy resources to meet those expectations. And I know Minister Farnworth's working with E-Division, working with his officials in public safety to make sure that everybody's on the same page, and I'm confident by the end of the week we will be.
Tanya Fletcher, CBC.
Just a little further to that, Premier. I mean, it's been more than a week since you first announced the new travel restrictions. As Lisa mentioned, the road checks still aren't sorted out. You're saying later this week. Any more specifics and why the delay? Is it simply pushback from police? And if so, what are the main sticking points with them?
I'm delighted to be here to talk about NBC, but also to talk about these issues. And I'm not suggesting that they're not important, but I think we've been pretty clear. I said last week restrictions were coming. Get ready for it. I've talked to the tourism sector. I've talked to the Hotel Association just today, restaurant and hospitality sector, trying to make sure that we've got buy-in for all of these initiatives. And I have to say, I'm very impressed with how the umbrella organizations for our tourism and hotel sector have stepped up and done their part to protect British Columbians so that we can look at a positive reopening after the May long weekend and get back to something resembling normal. But I said on Monday we're going to have restrictions by Friday. We do. The minister responsible said we'll have enforcement mechanisms in place by this week. We will.
And do you have a follow-up?
Yes. And as recently as late Friday, even after Minister Farnworth gave his most recent update, the RCMP union, for one, seemed hopeful that your government may back off on the checkpoint system altogether, or at least mobilizing police to enforce it. Are you still guaranteeing that particular aspect will go ahead and use officers to do it?
Well, again, we've been working with E-Division, which is for those who are uninitiated on these terms, E stands for British Columbia. Ask the RCMP why that is. And so we've been working with the RCMP here in British Columbia about where we can strategically locate counterattack type checkpoints to remind British Columbians and to educate them on the importance of staying local. Enforcement tools will be made known later in the week by Minister Farnworth, and we're collaborating and focusing on finding the best way forward. Minister Farnworth also met with representatives from the BIPOC community to hear their concerns, and we've incorporated that in how we've constructed the orders and how we'll deal with enforcement. And then it will fall to law enforcement to make their choices about how they will implement that. At ferry terminals, of course, we have mostly RCMP, but the Delta Municipal Force would be called upon in Tawasin, and the West Vancouver Force would be called upon at Horseshoe Bay. So we're working with, Minister Farnworth is working with law enforcement to make sure we're all comfortable with this. And I appreciate that the time between announcement and delivery is frustrating for people. But I also understand that people are responding. They get it. They understand that we all have to hold together here, and moving from one health authority to another is not in the best interest of salvaging our summer. And so people are already responding before the enforcement tools are in place, and I think that's a good thing.